News alert. President Trump's critics wasting no time slamming the president after Iran launched an attack on our troops in Iraq.
This is a president who is impulsive and doesn't think through the implications of his actions.
It's a setback for our security. It's a setback for our interests in the region.
It is a reminder where Donald Trump has taken us, and that is right to the edge of war.
All right, but should there be this level of political infighting at a time like this? Here to debate that, Trump 2020 Advisory Board member Steve Rogers and former Deputy Assistant Secretary of State under President Obama, Joel Rubin. Gentlemen, thanks for coming on today. Steve, I want to start with
you. Good morning, Rob.
This makes us seem quite divided at a very critical time.
Look, the President of the United States, he absolutely, without any doubt, managed this crisis with extraordinary leadership. Unfortunately, the Democrats are sending a very clear message to our enemies that we are divided. We are not. The country is standing behind the president, and it's about time that the Democrats put their politics aside and support this president, because supporting him is supporting our troops and supporting our country against our enemies.
Joel, your response.
Well, the country doesn't have to unite behind a regime change policy, and that's what the president's pursuing. And we're on a path to war, and the president has no authorization
for it.
Hey, so it's not.
Joel, you come right out the gate. He just tried to de-escalate everything with that speech yesterday.
No, Rob, we are on a trajectory, and we have been for the past several years, and in particular the last half year, towards military conflict. And nothing the president said yesterday is getting us off that path. And I don't see why having opposition to that is a bad thing. There are many Republicans in Congress who also are opposed to the idea of a war with Iran, and they want authorization. That's not happening, and that's the problem here.
Ilhan Omar, Steve, put out this tweet. I want to read it to you. This makes no sense. Sanctions are economic warfare. They have already caused medical shortages and countless deaths in Iran. You cannot claim you want de-escalation and then announce new sanctions with no clear goal. This is not a measured response. Ilhan kind of going the Obama route, using the carrot instead of the stick. What do you think of that idea after what we saw with Obama's presidency?
Well, look, we've been on a path to war because of the weak policies of past administrations. This president has stepped up. He's spoken up. He's taken effective action against terrorism, against the state of Iran. And he is looking to do what? He's looking to create a path to peace. He has said that. He has been consistent. And he did a great job in addressing this issue, keeping us out of war instead of getting us into a war.
Joel, I don't know how we can say we're getting off a path to war when we're getting hit by Iranian missiles on military bases in Iraq that we weren't getting hit by.
I'm glad you brought up the Iranian missiles, because I do want to segue into the second topic. The president says that you guys paid for those missiles with all that money that you sent over to Iran trying to appease them and get them to sign the nuclear deal. What do you say?
You're talking about an economy that has nearly $500 billion annual GDP, $50 billion budget. The missiles were developed indigenously inside of Iran. The money from the nuclear deal did not go directly to that. The money is fungible.
Maybe not directly. But you did feed a regime that then took your money and ignored its own people and spent it on proxy militias and terrorism.
No, but Rob, even under these sanctions for 3 years now that the president has enacted, where he is, in his view, starving the Iranian regime, they're advancing their missile program. So the idea that somehow Obama is responsible when the president's owned this for 3 years is really stretching it.
Okay. Gentlemen, we do have to leave it there. I do appreciate your time this morning.
Thanks.
36 minutes after the hour.